بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يهد الله ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، verily all praise and glory is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is due to Him and Him alone. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Him for His mercy, and we seek His forgiveness. And we testify that there is no God or deity worthy of worship but Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and last messenger. O ye who believe, fear Allah the fear that He is most deserving of you, and do not die unless you are in the state of al-Islam. يقول الحق سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الإسراء: إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Isra, verse number 9, verily this Qur'an guides to that which is most just and most right. And it gives glad tidings to the believers who work righteous deeds that they will have a great reward. Our topic for today, my brothers and sisters, ma huwa, what is the great reward that Allah has set in store for those who follow the guidance of the Qur'an and the mercy of the Qur'an in which Allah has sent to us through the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is our topic for today. And wallahi, I have intended this khutbah to remind myself, before reminding any of you, of the blessings of reciting the Qur'an, and the blessings of memorizing the Qur'an, and the blessings of studying the Qur'an, because I have seen what has happened to the ummah. And I am sure you have also seen. If I ask how many of us, what is in store for somebody who has memorized the Qur'an, I am sure out of you maybe half will be able to answer. مَا هُوَ فَضْلُ الْقُرْآنِ وَتِلَاوَتِهِ وَحِفْظِهِ. What is the blessing and the reward for the person who has memorized the Qur'an? Or the person who is a sahib of the Qur'an, a companion of the Qur'an? What is the blessing for somebody who recites the Qur'an آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Somebody who reads the Qur'an in the daytimes and at the night. What is his blessing? From the words of Allah and from the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هذا هو موضوعنا اليوم. This is our topic for today. ولا غيره. We will not go into the sharia that is found in the Qur'an. And we will not go into the tafsir of the Qur'an. And we will not go into the tajweed of the Qur'an. All we will focus on today is فضل القرآن وتلاوته وحفظه. The rewards and the blessings of reading the Qur'an and its memorization and its recitation. This is our topic. But before we begin, I wish to clarify the point and to emphasize the point that the Qur'an was sent for us as a guide, as a huda, and as a rahmah, as in the many verses in Kitab Allah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this evident to us. From them, the beginning of Surah Luqman. Alif Lam Mim. Tilka ayatul kitab al-hakim. Hudan wa rahmatan lil-muhsineen. Alif Lam Mim. Verily these are the verses of the wise book, Al-Quran. Hudan, a guidance. Wa rahmatan, and a mercy. To whom? Lil-muhsineen. To those who do good. deeds and do righteous deeds. This is what the Quran to us mu'mins and us believers is. It is a huda and it is a rahmah. Now let us begin to understand some of the blessings and some of the rewards of reciting the Quran. Why must we recite the Quran? عن أبي ذر رضي الله عنه قال قلت يا رسول الله أوصني قال عليك بتقوى الله فإنه رأس الأمر كله قلت يا رسول الله زدني قال عليك بتلاوة القرآن فإنه نور لك في الأرض وذخر لك في السماء والحديث رواه ابن حبان في صحيحه وغيره. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when he was asked for some advice from Abu Dharr, he said, I order you to have the fear and the consciousness of Allah. For this is the head of all matters. This is the top and the most important thing for you to have. قلت يا رسول الله زدني, I asked, O Messenger of Allah, increase me in advice. He said, I order you to recite the Quran. The reason is, it is a nur or a light for you in this earth. Nurun laka fil ard, it is a light for you on the earth. Wa dhukrun laka fis samaa, and it is a treasure that is kept for you in the sky. This is the first blessing. A treasure that is kept for you in the sky. Wa qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam aydan fi al-hadith alladhi rawahu al-Imam Muslim, iqra'u al-Qur'an فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. A order from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith that is authentic and narrated by Imam Muslim. I order you to recite the Quran because it will come in the day of resurrection. In يوم القيامة, it will come for its companions to intercede on their behalf, to make shafa'ah. The Qur'an will come and make shafa'ah for you in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if Allah wishes. And the Qur'an, as we will see in the later ahadith, will ask Allah to beautify you. And it will ask Allah to admit you to the Jannah and many, many, many great rewards that are set in store for the companion of the Qur'an. And wallahi, there are many of us who are companions of the Qur'an. For wallahi, the buses and the subways are never empty from those who recite the Qur'an in the buses and the subways. And wallahi, there are many of us who listen to the Qur'an on our headphones when we are walking in the street. And there are many of us who have the Qur'an in their memory, and they are walking, when they are walking in the street, they recite. صاحب القرآن, a companion of the Qur'an. الذي يأمر بأمره وينهى بنهيه. Those from the companions of the Qur'an who order what the Qur'an orders, tells you to do what the Qur'an orders you to do, and tells you to stay away from what the Qur'an has forbidden for you. صاحب القرآن. The Qur'an will come in the day of judgment and it will try to make shafa'ah for him in front of Allah. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the third blessing, يجيء صاحب القرآن يوم القيامة فيقول القرآن رب حله فيلبس تاج الكرامة فيقول القرآن رب زده فيلبس حلة الكرامة فيقول يا رب ارض عنه فيرضى عنه فيقول رب ارض عنه فيرضى عنه. والحديث رواه الترمذي وابن خزيمة والحاكم وقال صحيح. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, The companion of the Qur'an will be brought in the day of judgment. And the Qur'an will say, O my Lord, Ya Rabbi, Hallih, dress him in beauty. فَيَلْبِسُ تَاجَ الْكَرَامَةِ, he will be given a crown of honor. A crown of honor. When the honor is where it should be. يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, this is the most honor you can get. Not something that you will get in this dunya and die and nobody will remember your name. يوم القيامة, the sahib of the Qur'an will be given a crown of honor. And it will not just stop there. Then the Qur'an will say, Ya Rabbi Zidhu, O my Lord, increase him. Increase him. And then he will be given the jewelry of those who are honorable. the jewelry of Yawm al-Qiyamah. You will be dressed in the jewelry of those who are honorable. And then the blessing just does not stop there. Then the Quran will say, oh my Lord, be happy and content with him. And Allah will be happy and content with him. And this hadith is narrated by Tirmidhi and Ibn Khuzaymah and Al-Hakim, who said is authentic. The fourth blessing. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد. يقول الصيام يا رب إني منعته الطعام والشراب بالنهار فشفعني فيه. ويقول القرآن رب منعته النوم بالليل فشفعني فيه. فيشفعان. والحديث رواه أحمد وابن أبي الدنيا والطبراني وقال الحاكم صحيح على شرط مسلم. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said in an authentic hadith, he said that fasting, الصيام and the Quran are two things that will make shafa'ah, will come and make intercession for you. The fasting will say, oh my Lord, I stopped him from eating and drinking in the daylight hours. Oh my Lord, allow me to make shafa'ah for him. And then the Quran will say, oh my Lord, I stopped him from sleeping at night because he used to recite me. Oh my Lord, allow me to make shafa'ah for him. فَيَشْفَعَانِ. They will be given the ability to make shafa'ah. They will be given the ability to make shafa'ah. And the hadith is narrated by Imam Ahmad and Ibn Abi Dunya and Al-Tabrani. And Al-Hakim said this is a hadith which is at the level of the hadith in Sahih Muslim. This is another blessing. The Quran will make shafa'ah for you in many different ways in the Day of Judgment. But do not become greedy and think that the blessing is just to you. لا تظن أن الفضل لك. Do not think that the blessing is just for you. كلا. But the blessing is for you and your parents. The blessing is for you and your parents. Your parents will also be rewarded for you having memorized or learned the Quran. The proof is the hadith which is narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قرأ القرآن وتعلم وعمل به ألبس والداه تاجا من نور ضوءه مثل ضوء الشمس ويكسى والداه حلتين لا يقوم لهما الدنيا فيقولا بما كسين هذا فيقال بأخذ ولدكم القرآن بأخذ ولدكم القرآن. والحديث رواه الحاكم وقال صحيح على شرط مسلم وغيره. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the person who has memorized or who has learned the Quran, and he has learned it, and he lives by its rules, meaning he does what it orders and he stays away from what it forbids. ويعمل به. For him, his parents will be dressed with a crown of light. تاجا من نور. ضوءه مثل ضوء الشمس. The light, the brightness of this crown will surpass the brightness of the sun. In يوم القيامة. The crown will be brighter than the sun. And not just that. Then they will be given the jewelry. Then they will be given jewelry. The earth itself is not worth this jewelry. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. But it does not stop there. And when they ask, why have we been given this reward and this blessing? We have not done anything. Why are we getting this reward? And it will be said to them, بِأَخْذِ وَلَدِكُمُ الْقُرْآنِ. Because your son or your daughter or your child has taken the Qur'an. Has taken the Qur'an. What more of an incitement is there for you to bring your son or your daughter to the masjid? To bring them to the Sunday school where they will learn a verse of the Qur'an. Ayah. One verse. Is it better than for them than to stay at home and watch TV? Wallahi, it is better for them. You will get thawab for your gas, and you will get thawab for the money you put, and you will get thawab for the time you take out to bring them to the masjid. And if you cannot, bring them a teacher to you. And if you cannot, bring them to a special teacher. And if you cannot, teach them yourself. Teach them yourself. In order that you will have this great blessing and this great reward in the Day of Judgment. In order that you will receive this great reward in the Day of Judgment. And I am sure that there are many brothers and sisters who are listening today. And they are thinking to themselves, Ya Laytana, we wish that we could speak the Arabic language to teach our children Arabic. And then there are others who wish they had money in order to bring them to the school. And then there are others who wish that they could read the Quran. And I will narrate this hadith for them and you. Where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in a hadith which is narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الماهر بالقرآن مع السفرة الكرام البررة والذي يتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق له أجران. والحديث رواه البخاري ومسلم وأبو داود والترمذي وابن ماجه والنسائي وغيرهم. In an authentic agreed upon hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the skilled al-mahir, the skilled person at reciting the Qur'an, will be at the level in the Day of Judgment of the scribes who are most honorable and obedient. مع الملائكة مع السفرة الكرام البررة. He will be with them. والذي يقرأ القرآن. And as for the person who recites the Qur'an, ويتعتع فيه, cannot complete the word, and cannot complete the verse, and have trouble with the tajweed, and have trouble with the tashkeel. وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَاقٌ. And he finds great hardship and difficulty in its recitation. لَهُ أَجْرَانٌ. He has double the reward, or he has two times the reward, or he has twice the reward. And this hadith is agreed upon. And narrated by Bukhari and Muslim and Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood and Nisa'i and Ibn Majah and many, many others. Many, many others. This is your blessing for not being able to read the Quran properly until you learn. But you do not say, then I don't want to learn. I want double the reward. I don't want to learn. Why go to school if I get double the reward? Because you will never be at the level of the angels until you are a mahir. This is their reward. If you want to reach this reward, you are to learn. And while you are learning, you get double the reward. And wallahi, if it was just for this next hadith, wallahi, if it was just for this next and last hadith before Jilsatul Istiraha, if it was just for this hadith, it would have been enough for us to know that the importance of the Quran and its recitation. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. والحديث رواه البخاري ومسلم وأبو داود وغيرهم. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever recites a letter from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has a hasana. He has a good deed just for reciting this one letter. وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا. And the hasana is 10 times its normal amount. So now it's 10 hasana for one letter. And I do not mean by saying alif lam mim is one letter. What I mean is alif is a letter, walam is a letter, and meem is another letter. By saying alif lam meem, you have 30 hasanat. 30 hasanat. What if you recite Surah Al-Baqarah? What if you recite Surah Al-Baqarah in one time? What if you finish the Quran within 3 days? And keep on doing this for a month? How many hasanat do you have then? Wallahi, the greatest computer couldn't compute it in a second. It would take him longer than that because the reward is much greater. This is what I wish to incite you for. And wallahi, I'm reminding myself of the reward of the Quran before I'm reminding you. Because I have seen, and I have, as I have said before, that the Quran has been lost by the Ummah. The Quran now is just given as a gift. Oh, mashallah, akhi, you have memorized the juz? Take the Quran. Here, this is your gift. It has been given, it is becoming something symbolical, not something religious. Al-Quran is our shara. It is our law. It is what we live and order ourselves by and stay away from what it orders us not to do. This is what the Quran represents to us as Muslims. It is not a song that we listen to in our cars or our stores. It is our shara. It is our law. This is what the Quran represents to us. What a great blessing. Your law, for reading your law, for reading your law, you get hasanat. For reading your ahkam of this religion, for reading the rules that you live by, you are getting hasanat. Subhanallah. What greater a reward is there for studying the tafsir and studying the sharia and studying the fiqh of the Quran? And this, wallahi, is what I wish to leave you by for the first khutbah. And now I will sit in Jilsat al-Istiraha. And after I stand up, I wish to complete with you the topic of today. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم يا فوز المستغفرين استغفروا ربكم إن الله غفور رحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد. ماذا بعد حفظ سورة؟ وماذا بعد حفظ آية؟ What is there for us to do after memorizing the whole Quran? Or what is there for us to do after memorizing one surah? Or what is there for us to do after memorizing just one ayah? What is your responsibility as a Muslim? What is your responsibility as somebody who has memorized just one verse of the Quran? قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. What is your responsibility with this verse? I am sure everyone here knows قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. What is your responsibility? The answer comes from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, حيثuma يقول, بلغوا عني ولو آية. Instruct, or teach, or order, or inform people about me and this religion, even if it is by reciting one verse. آية, ولو آية, even if it is by one verse. This is our manhaj. This is our methodology. This is our da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our lifeline, Al-Quran. This is our life. This is what we have in our chests and our hearts. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. This is in your heart. Balligh. Inform. Tell people. Teach your son. 2 years old. Qul la ilaha illallah. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. If you have taught him, go to somebody else who does not know. And if you have taught that verse, memorize another one if this is the only one you know. Teach it to another person. ما معنى الفاتحة الكتاب? What is the meaning of Surah Al-Fatiha? What is the meaning of Surah Al-Ikhlas? Teach the people. Teach yourself and then teach the people. بلغوا عني ولو آية. Even if it is one verse. And wallahi, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not place teaching as the best of professions, sudan wala hamala. He did not just leave teaching the Quran as the best of things to be done from his own opinion. Where he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. متفق عليه. The best of you, the best of people in this ummah, are those who learn and acquire knowledge of the Quran and then teach it. وعلمه. The best. This is the best, the pinnacle, the top thing you can do in Islam. تعلم الناس القرآن. This is our minhaj, as I will say again. This is our methodology and the way we do things in Islam. This is our da'wah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But do not think that what I mean is that just following the Quran. Kalla. Because the sunnah is just as important. For the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, إني قد تركت فيكم ما إن اعتصمتم به لن تضلوا أبدا كتاب الله وسنة نبيه والحديث رواه الحاكم وصححه شيخنا الألباني حفظه الله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I have left something with you that if you remain steadfast and hold on to, you will never be misguided, you will never become deviant, you will never stray away. The book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فإن ضيعنا إحداهما, if we lose either one, ضللنا, we would become misguided. By the words of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. For the Quran itself is complemented by the sunnah. The Quran says, وما أتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. Whatever the messenger has brought for you, take it. And what he has ordered you to stay away from, leave it alone. This is the Quran. The Quran is complemented by the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And wallahi, the state of this ummah has never reached its lowest except by us leaving the Quran. ضيعنا القرآن فضعنا. We have left and we have forgotten the Quran, so we ourselves were forgotten by the other nations. Do you think the UN nation cares anything about a Muslim? Wallahi, do you think that they care? Look what is happening. Look around you, almost every corner of the earth. Look and say, أين المسلمون? You don't have to find a map. You don't have to find a map that says, where are the Muslims? Just look where there is trouble, where there are bombings, where there are deaths. And you will know where the Muslims are. This is the state of the ummah. Ghutaa! We are like the suds of the ocean. We are many, but we cannot do nothing. We cannot say anything. When we talk, we are blowing wind. And the reason? ضيعنا القرآن. We have forgotten the Qur'an. And we have forgotten the blessing of teaching the Qur'an to ourselves and our children. نحن نريد جيل القرآن وجيل أهل السنة. We need a new generation of people who follow the Qur'an and who follow the sunnah. This is what you can قدموا. This is what you can bring forth for yourself and for the Muslims who are coming in the future. This is what I wish to conclude and leave you with today. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remind us from the Qur'an that which we have forgotten, and to let us remember that which we have forgotten from the Qur'an, and to let us memorize from the Qur'an that which we do not know. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وبارك اللهم لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يضل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأقم الصلاة.